Huawei, the world's largest maker of telecom equipment, became a global leader in designing cutting-edge chips, rivaling those made by Samsung, Apple, and Nvidia. But ever since the US imposed sanctions against Huawei in 2019, the Chinese tech giant has been losing its foothold in the global smartphone market.
The restrictions that came down on Huawei in 2019 certainly took the company by surprise. The US for a long time saw the company as a national security threat, but it took quite a few years for Washington to kind of really mobilize itself and take some serious action against the company.
A spike in demand has contributed to the global chip shortage, but ongoing US-China political frictions have exacerbated the situation for Huawei. So what led the US to impose restrictions on the Chinese tech giant? First, the US has long seen Huawei as a national security threat, especially as it was advancing so quickly in 5G technology.
This was seen as a problem among some US policymakers who have long been concerned that Huawei telecommunications gear can in some way be intercepted or tapped by the Chinese government.
Huawei has denied this allegation. Two more reasons for the restrictions: allegations of intellectual property theft and violation of trade sanctions. In 2019, the US charged Huawei with attempting to steal trade secrets from T-Mobile and with violating trade sanctions against Iran.
The alleged fraudulent financial schemes used by Huawei and its chief financial officer were not just illegal, but detrimental to the security of the United States.
Huawei previously denied all of these allegations, but in September, the company's CFO reached a deal with the U.S., admitting to some wrongdoing in the Iran trade sanctions case. Both cases are still ongoing. Later in 2019, the U.S. placed Huawei on what's called the Entity List, banning U.S. companies like Google and Qualcomm from working with Huawei. Then in 2020, the U.S. tightened the terms of the Entity Listing twice, cutting Huawei off from its own chip manufacturers and then later blocking Huawei from accessing any chip built using U.S. technology.
U.S. technology is so deeply embedded in this supply chain, so this was a truly destructive measure that blocked the company from chip makers, not just in the U.S., but in Taiwan, in Europe, even in mainland China.
Despite the restrictions, any company that wants to sell to Huawei can apply for a license from the U.S. government, but these are often difficult to get.
For example, Qualcomm is able to sell 4G chip technology to Huawei. Other companies are selling more rudimentary chips to Huawei. And you can see that that's really an offshoot of this underlying desire in policy circles in Washington to rein in Huawei's 5G technology without totally sort of choking off the company from any components whatsoever.
Since September 2020, Huawei has been relying on its stockpile of chips, but its supply is now running low. Huawei is investing in domestic chip makers, but it could still take them years to catch up to U.S. technology. Huawei released a new phone in July, but without high-tech chips, it can't connect to 5G networks, and analysts say it will struggle to compete globally. In September, Huawei Deputy Chairman Eric Xu said the company's smartphone revenue will drop by up to $40 billion this year. And so far, there haven't been any signs from Washington that the U.S. will loosen these restrictions.
You're seeing Huawei pull back on 5G. You're seeing Huawei lose out on 5G contracts. You're seeing its 5G phone sales totally collapse. And in many ways, this was the goal of some of the sanctions.